Good evening, and welcome to Prince of Peace Parish. I'm your lector, Mary O'Rourke. Father Paul Colling celebrates our Eucharistic liturgy. For those of you who are returning to Mass, welcome. We are so glad you are here. For community indoor mask mandate is in effect for the city of Kearney. Thank you for your cooperation with this public safety measure. If you desire to receive communion on the tongue, please wait until the end of the communion line. The readings and opening song tonight, Silent Night, can be found in the bulletin. Please stand.
We gather ourselves in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Welcome, everyone, especially those who are visiting here today on the vigil of the Solemnity of Mary, Mother of God. What a great way to ring in the new year is to come to Mass. This Mass is typically prayed for in honor of Mary, the Mother of Jesus, but also for world peace. As we begin this celebration, let us ask the Lord to bring peace in our soul and let us seek his love and forgiveness. I confess to Almighty God and you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and my words, what I have done and what I have failed to do, through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask Blessed Mary, our Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us of our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Amen. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Through the fruitful virginity of the Blessed Mary, bestowed on the human race the grace of eternal salvation, grant, we pray, that we may experience the intercession of her through whom we were found worthy to receive the author of life, our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever. Amen.
A reading from the book of Numbers. The Lord said to Moses, "Speak to Aaron and his sons and tell them, this is how you shall bless the Israelites. Say to them, the Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord let his face shine upon you and be gracious to you. The Lord look upon you kindly and give you peace. So shall they invoke my name upon the Israelites, and I will bless them." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
nations on the earth you guide. May God bless us in his mercy. May the peoples praise you, O God. May all the peoples praise you. May God bless us, and may all the ends of the earth fear him. May God bless us in his mercy.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Galatians. Brothers and sisters, when the fullness of time had come, God sent his Son, born of a woman, born under the law, to ransom those under the law, so that we might receive adoptions as sons. A proof that you are sons, God sent the Spirit of his Son into our hearts, crying out, Abba, Father. So you are no longer a slave, but a son. And if a son, then also an heir through God. The word of the Lord. Thanks be to God.
The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke. The shepherds went in haste to Bethlehem and found Mary and Joseph and the infant lying in the manger. When they saw this, they made known the message that had been told them about the child. All who heard it were amazed by what was been told to them by the shepherds. And Mary kept all these things, reflecting on them in her heart. Then the shepherds returned, glorifying and praising God for all they had heard and seen, just as it had been told to them. When the 8 days were completed for her circumcision, he was named Jesus, the name given him by the angel before he was conceived in the womb. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
So tonight we celebrate the vigil of the feast or the Solemnity of Mary, the Mother of God. And again, as I said, we're also asked to pray for world peace. I'd like to begin with a poem by William Arthur Ward. It goes like this. Another fresh new year is here, another year to live, to banish worry, doubt, and fear, to love and laugh and give. This bright new year is given me to live each day with zest, to daily grow and try to be my highest and my best. to have the opportunity once more to right some wrongs, to pray for peace, to plant a tree, and sing more joyful songs. Tonight we will close a chapter on 2020, and tomorrow we'll open the chapter on 2021. Many of us are happy to see 2020 in the rearview mirror. But what a wonderful place to ring in the new year. And more wonderful than that, to remember Mary, the Virgin Mother of Jesus. We hold Mary up as a historic woman in history because she took a leap of faith and said yes to God, to be an instrument, a vessel, to open the new age of salvation history. The old age where God and humanity were distant was finally closed. With the birth of Jesus, the new age, the new Adam, had begun. And we are living proof that we believe that Jesus came to save the world. Mary is a model for us of one who is obedient to God's will. Many people don't like the idea that there is a being greater than ourselves, one that we call to listen to. We're called to listen to. The reason is because our society is trying to convince us that God does not exist, that God is dead. And if that is true, then we're more apt to listen to the wrong voices in the world, those that would lead us away from God, more apt to listen to our own voices, to listen to our own desire and our own will. Those of you who are here tonight, you know that listening to that world voice that causes us to move away from God, that road leads to sadness, dissolution, and even death. When we choose God, we choose life and life to the abundance. In the gospel, there's a line I would like to focus on tonight, and the word I'm changing a little bit, that instead of reflected, I'm using the word ponder, but Mary pondered on these things and reflected on them in her heart. I always find the opening of a new year is a time to do a little bit of assessment, to use the guiding principles of our faith, the Ten Commandments, the acts of mercy and charity, to see if we are living up, if I'm living up to the standards of God and the gospel, to love God with the whole heart, mind, and soul, and love our neighbor as ourselves. It seems to me more often than not, the older we get, the more time that we have to think about, to reflect. And what I'd rather us not do is to reflect on our mistakes or worry what we didn't do or should have done or could have done. Oh, that's important. Our tradition calls us to do an examination of conscience, to remember that we're not perfect and that sin is part of our life, to examine our conscience and remember that Jesus came to save us and forgive us, and by his grace and effort, we're able to change. But after we do that little examination of conscience, I propose that you and I, we move beyond looking upon on our faults. I encourage us all to ponder things that we have done well and ask God to help us multiply these things to increase. To look back this past year and remind ourselves that yes, we have been patient and charitable and kind and unselfish and looked out for the others. Have we done it perfectly? No, but we have tried. We want to remember those times and be that kind of person and even do better in 2021. So as we enter 2021, let's use the Blessed Virgin Mary as a model to help us in our New Year's resolution. First of all, Mary was faithful to her Jewish tradition, and she took Jesus to the temple after he was 8 days old, as was commanded in Genesis. So let us be resolved to be faithful to our tradition, the Roman Catholic Church. So this first tradition, and also invite you to make a resolution to go to Mass. God willing, it won't be long that the dispensation will be lifted and we'll have the Sunday obligation. My dream, and many priests and the bishops too, would be that when we are no longer abstained or lifted from that dispensation that our churches would be full, every pew, standing room only. Wouldn't that be wonderful? So let's make a resolution to make Mass every Sunday and the holy days of obligation. Another resolution that might be a good one for us to do is to continue a prayerful, being prayerful. If we haven't, to form a prayerful habit of reflecting on God. Just like it said in the gospel, Mary pondered on what was said was happening. She reflected on these events. As Plato said, an unexamined life is not worth living. When we had the lockdown, and even after, many people found they had more time on their hands. Some did not. For many people, this was challenging because they were so busy with their life that they never had a chance to really reflect on their life. And they were face to face with themselves, as if a mirror was put into their face. And they didn't always like what they see. But I would encourage you to look as God sees, just as a parent, to look with the eyes of love. So as we enter this new year, let's carve out some more time for quiet time. If we don't make an appointment for ourselves to pray, it most likely won't happen. Perhaps coming for 15 minutes in the church and sit in front of the Blessed Sacrament and just be still. Put that old cell phone in the car and leave it there. Or come for Eucharistic adoration on Thursday and Friday and just let the Lord love you. So maybe that could be our second resolution, to form a habit of prayer. And the third resolution might be a little strange to you, but it would be, let us trust God. As St. Pope John Paul II said, don't be afraid. Mary trusted when the angel told her she was to have a son. She trusted that God would help her break the news to Jesus so that he wouldn't divorce her. She trusted that God when she saw her son die on the cross. Her trust helped her see that God brought the good news and God can help us when difficult things happen. And she was privileged to see the risen Lord. With this worldwide pandemic, I imagine many people have been having a difficult time of trusting God. After hearing the death toll, it's so hard for many to trust God. It's easy to believe that God has let us down. But we live in an imperfect world where bad things happen to good people. Trusting in God will help us realize that whatever this life throws at us, we can handle it because we are not alone. If we depend just on ourselves and our abilities, well then, yes, we're going to go down a road where we can't get out. But we're not alone. We have the Holy Family, Mary, and Joseph, to inspire us and pray for us. We have our church family to support us and to pray for us. And we have our Savior Jesus and the grace of God. Even though 2020 had a lot of difficult circumstances, there were some blessings too. The whole world worked together to get this vaccine. Many, many people performed countless works of charity. So life is fragile. Let us handle it with prayer. Let us resolve to trust in God. The only way we can be the person that God wants us to be is to be in union with God. And that will happen in our prayer life. So this new year, I invite you all to make a resolution to follow your tradition, attend Mass, to make a resolution to be prayerful, and to trust in the Lord. Do come here and be fed by the Word of God and the body and blood and soul divinity of Christ. And we'll be on a journey to do what we desire, to become the best version of ourselves. And that when the Lord calls us home, he'll say, well done, good and faithful servant. Let us stand and profess our faith. I believe in one God. And invisible. I believe in one Lord, Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate Mary, and became man. For our sake, he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and life of the world to come. Amen. And now let us turn to God with our prayers of intercession. Through the Holy Spirit, Mary became the Virgin Mother of Christ. With the Blessed Mother, we offer our intercessions.
For the whole church, that God's wisdom may strike root among us in the person of Jesus, making us a glorious people, the portion of the Lord and the company of his holy ones. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That God, who sends forth his command to the earth, may enable world leaders to keep his word so that he may grant peace in our borders. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all of us as we celebrate this Christmas season, that the eyes of our hearts may be enlightened, and we may know what is the hope that belongs to our call in Christ Jesus. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the Word who was made flesh may give all those who believe in his name power to become children of God, shedding in his light in the world by their lives of faith and good works. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who are abandoned and forgotten in their need and suffering, that our prayer and love may encircle them with joy and new beginnings of life. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our faithful departed ones, that God may bless them in Christ with every spiritual blessing in his heavenly home, giving them eternal rest and peace. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all of our intentions, especially for our Prince of Peace parishioners, and for all of our deceased loved ones for whom this Mass is offered, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
God, our Father, you blessed Mary as your chosen maiden, handmaid. Strengthen us as we join her song of thanksgiving. We ask this through your Son, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen.
Thank you.
pray, sisters and brothers, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. O God, who in your kindness began all good things and bring them to fulfillment, grant to us who find joy in the solemnity of the Holy Mother of God, that just as we glory in the beginning of your grace, so one day we rejoice in its completion. Through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you. And with your spirit, lift up your heart. We lift them up to the Lord. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is right and just. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty, Eternal God, and to praise, bless, and glorify your name on the solemnity of the motherhood of the Blessed Ever Virgin Mary. For by the overshadowing of the Holy Spirit, she conceived your only begotten Son, and without losing the glory of her virginity, brought forth into the world the eternal light, Jesus Christ our Lord. Through him all the angels praise your majesty. Dominions adore and powers tremble before you. And heaven and the virtues of heaven and the blessed seraphim worship together in exaltation. And so may our voices, we pray, join with theirs in humble praise as we acclaim this holy hymn. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, that they may become for us the body and blood of your Son, O Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and willingly into his passion, he took bread and giving thanks, he broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, once more giving thanks. He gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for the many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
Save us, save us, Savior of the world, for by your cross and resurrection you have set us free.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks as you've held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking in the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world. Bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis our Pope and Joseph our Bishop and all the clergy. Remember our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, the Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, your spouse, with the blessed apostles, the martyrs, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life. We may praise you and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ.
Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil, and graciously grant peace in our day, that by the help of your mercy we may always be free from sin and safe from all distress, as we wait the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with the will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other a sign of peace at a social distance.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those who are called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord,
Father.
Let us pray. Grant, we pray, having received this heavenly sacrament with joy, O Lord, grant, we pray, that we may lead us to eternal life. For we rejoice to proclaim the blessed ever virgin, mother of your Son, and the mother of the church. Through Christ our Lord, who lives and reigns forever and ever. Amen. Amen. So the weekend bulletins are out if you want to take one, or wait till you come back to church, because that's what the music is in for the weekend. There are books to give away. You can take them or give them away to people that you know. That might be a way of evangelization. And the Magnificat is available. You can take it for the whole month of January. Bow your head and receive God's blessing. May God, the source of origin of all blessing, grant you grace and bestow his blessing in abundance, keep you safe from all harm throughout this new year, forever and ever.
Amen.
May God give you integrity and faith, endurance and hope, perseverance and charity, and the holy patience to the end.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. May God order your days and your deeds in his peace. Grant your prayers in this and in every place, and lead you happily to eternal life. Amen.
Amen.
And may the blessing of God, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit come down upon you and remain forever. Amen.
Amen.
Go and announce the gospel of the Lord. Thanks be to God. Won't you join me as we pray the prayer of Michael, the archangel? St. Michael, the archangel.
Defend us from battle.
May God rebuke him, we humbly pray. And do thou, O Prince of heavenly hosts, by the power of God, thrust into hell Satan and other evil spirits who prowl about the world for the ruin of souls. Amen.
Amen.
And won't you join me in the dismissal song?